Okay, M-class dust extraction.
Check.
Auto start stop feature.
Check.
Drive act capability and attachments.
Check.
Wet vac capability and attachments.
Check.
5 meter hose.
Check.
Universal adapter.
Check.
Oh, less than half the price of the equivalent Merkur of Festool.
Check.
Well, hello again and welcome back to my channel. And may I introduce the brand new trend T33a M-class dust extractor with wet and dry vacuum capabilities. Now, if you are a regular subscriber to the channel, you will know that earlier this year, I entered into a collaboration with Trend Tools. And for the purposes of transparency, this unit has been gifted to me for a review. However, I am not under any obligation to say anything favorable, and I am going to call it as I see it. Well, it couldn't really have come at a better time, to be honest. If you've been following the channel, you know I'm right in the middle of the workshop build and the big job has broken out. So its versatility has really been tested, and I'll talk a little bit more about that a bit later on. Now, what I do find interesting about this kind of model is a lot of makers that I follow previously have had like bespoke dust extraction units within their workshop, and because they are moving to more mobile things like everything being on casters, then the dust extraction is having to follow suit as well. So they're tending to find themselves with a large type one for chippings from the planar thickness or whatever, which leaves space for one more, which would be something along the lines of this. Now, before we look into anything else, let's have a quick look to see what we get with the unit. Well, as the introduction stated, you do get M-class dust extraction, which is a step up from L-class. Now, I don't know loads about it, to be honest, but I've done a little bit of reading, and according to the Festool website, M-class is more suited to hardwoods and L-class is more suited to softwoods. Ooh, that could throw up a bit of a debate in the comment section, but please feel free to comment. Well, what else do we get? Well, you get a 5 meter hose, which should be more than adequate for the majority of UK workshops. You also get a dry vacuum head with thingy, and you also get a wet vacuum head and a universal adapter. Now, if we had a pound for every time a manufacturer said universal adapter and it wasn't quite, I'd probably be retired by now, but let's give it a quick check out with some of my tools. Well, I think I was as surprised as anyone. That works great with my Festool gear, also works fine with my budget stuff from Aldi, Ferrex, Workzone. So well done to Trend on that one. But apart from all the add-ons and stuff, what do you buy a dust extractor for? Well, obviously for dust extraction. And is it any good at that? Well, again, if you are a regular subscriber, you will know I've done a review of the Festool against the Merkur Deros using my Merkur dust extractor. I'm going to roll out that old piece of oak sleeper again, put it over some white cloth and sand it for 15 minutes using my Festool sander and the Trend T33A. And let's have a look what it's actually, is it any good for its primary purpose? Trying to get as much light on here as possible to show you that is incredible.
I'll move the sleeper now and let's see if we can see any lines. This part here, that was the underside of the oak sleeper, so it's not that. We're looking along here. And there's a tiny bit here, and there's a tiny bit there. Now, I know the Festool sander is renowned for its dust extraction, but you know, it's what it's hooked up to as well. And it's certainly done better than when I'd done the Festool Deros test last year and I had it hooked up to the Merkur. This is much, much better. Wow, that has surprised me. Okay, I've been using this for just over a month now, so I know how good it is because I've used it in a variety of applications. Up until now though, I hadn't done the oak sleeper test on the white sheet, and that was phenomenal, okay? I don't necessarily want to compare this directly to my current Merkur dust extractor because that's an L class and this is an M class. Having said that though, they are about the same retail price, and this has just absolutely wiped the floor with it. Seriously, seriously impressive that. Just thought about a couple of other logistical things that folk might be interested in before I start to look at the other bells and whistles it can do. Firstly, the powered on-off switch. When you plug your device, your tool in, and it's on the zero, which is off, it does not mean that your device is switched off. That's always powered on, and remember that. So then you've got it on the automatic on for when your device comes on, and also just switch it on as a vacuum. What I do like about the automatic bit is when I switch my device on, it runs for about 4 or 5 seconds after you've switched it off. Now, I think that's a really positive thing because my Merkur model doesn't do that. It switches straight off, but that doesn't mean you've got a 5 meter hose, so it still needs to get that dust extracted out once you've switched the device off, which I think is a good thing. Noise-wise, let's switch it on. I've got my iPad decibel meter reader thing, and let's have a little look what it is. That's giving it about 77, 78 decibels. Is that good or bad? I don't know. In fact, let's go and get me Merkur one, see what the difference is. About the same. Okay, so what other logistical things can we look at before we look at all the other bells and whistles that it can do? Firstly, it weighs in at just over 8 kilos, so it's nice and light. It has a 25 liter drum capacity, of which the bag capacity is just over 15 liters and the wet capacity is 17 liters. I'm not 100% sure why the drum's so much bigger. I'm guessing it's for the actual air to expand when it's switched on and the bag sort of blows up. Not literally, obviously. Couple of other bits of things. The actual release catches are nice and chunky, and it's really straightforward to replace the bag. Dead easy if I could do it. So if a guy working with one arm does it fine, you lot shouldn't have any other issues. Now, onto the other things it can do. In terms of building a workshop, having a dry vacuum became very, very handy indeed for a variety of reasons. It can be a very dusty place, you know, offcuts and stuff, and it dealt with that really well. Oh, yeah, so we've got this, and we've got the actual long arm with the dry vacuum head on it as well. The wet vacuum, again, come in really handy because for 3 weeks, I didn't have a roof on the workshop. Now, luckily, the weather was great, but obviously you get the moisture in the morning. So I was coming out, switching it to the wet vacuum mode, and then just getting that to get the moisture up to get it off the OSB floor. It isn't simply a case of flicking a switch and then you go, poof, wet vacuum. No, it's a little bit more complicated than that, but it only takes a minute or two. And I'll show you very quickly through these pictures. So as you can see, really straightforward to do. You've got to take the HEPA filter out, the M-class filter thing, replace that with a little membrane thing that goes around the outside, and then it's easy, and then you are into wet vacuuming mode. And it was very good as well. The collection of it was really impressive. So that covers more or less its capabilities. The 5 meter hose is excellent because it means you don't have to be right next to you whilst you're working. So even if you haven't got your earplugs in, you can have it a bit of a distance, which reduces the noise slightly more for you. Which brings me to the end of the video, and maybe it's trump card or it's ace up its sleeve, which I kind of hinted at in the introduction, and that's its price point. Okay, now I'll leave a link in the description to this, an Amazon link for UK users. And it's an affiliated link, so if you do click on it and order one, a few pennies do go to the channel, which would be much appreciated. But if you look on there, I looked this morning and it had discount code, and it's currently on Amazon in the UK for £209. Let me just repeat that again. That's £209 for an M-class dust extractor with wet and dry vac, auto stop start, 25 litres, should go on and on and on. That is incredible value for money. And then I'm going to hint at, if you looked at the equivalent specification for the likes of, say, Festool or Merca. Now look, we all know when you think dust extraction, you think Festool, you think Merca. They make incredible products. Right, they really do. I own some of both of their brands. But when you look at the price, and we'll hint up on the screen there, that is a huge difference between the price point between those and the Trend T33A, which takes me back to my early point about a lot of the makers that I follow on YouTube, and their attitudes have changed towards dust extraction. Instead of having these big bespoke units with all the shutters and everything fitted in, the workshop habits are changing. Everything's going on casters, everything's becoming more mobile, and also they're wanting to have a larger chip extractor type dust collection for like the planar thicknesser, and then have one multi-purpose for, say, sanding or the track saw or the bandsaw or something like that. Now, let me put it this way. You could get one of these, plus I was always looking at that Central Technology Systems. They do a 50 litre workshop dust collector for maybe if you're planar thicknesser or something like that. You could get one of these and one of those and also have a substantial chunk of change than if you opted for the Festool or the Merca equivalent specification of what this offers. Look, folks, it's a no-brainer. I don't need to sell it to you. I really like this. This is staying in my workshop, okay? Because, well, once it's finished, it is really good. I've demonstrated that. I've used it with a variety of other tools, including my track saw. I've got my little bandsaw there. And obviously my sanding and stuff, and it works really well. It's simple to use, it's simple to change the dust collection bag, which is great for me. If you need to switch it to the wet vac, again, you can do it in a minute or two, no problem there. And the wet vacuum is really good as well. Now, if you are interested in that, I hope this little video has helped you in some way, shape or form if you're thinking about investing in one of these. Look, I am available in the comments section, folks, if you need to get in touch, or via the social media, and there's links in all the description to that. As ever, everyone, take care, look after yourselves, and I'll see you soon. Thanks for watching.